Hi friends, this is Ankit from the guys computer and today we gonna learn about the network topologies. Network topology is a layout of a network. How a computer network is connected, either physical or when computer networks are connected logically. That means when data transfer in a predefined layout, then it is logical. Let's talking about the first topology. Here is a main cable and a lot of computers are connected to the main cable. This type of topology is known as bus topology. In this topology, all the computers are connected to the main hub or main cable or bus. Data flow in a single direction. It is cost effective. It's used in small networks like in your home. It's easy to expand, but it is slower and dependent on the main cable. That means if main cable fails, then all the other network will fail. Moving on to the next topology, these are the computers which are connected in a ring structure, which is known as ring topology. Now in this topology, data flows in unidirectional from there to there, but sometimes it can also happen on the other side. Such type, then it is known as dual ring topology. Now it is unaffected by high traffic. It is very cheap to install, but it is prone to failure. That means any of one computer in a ring fails, then all the network will fail. Let's move on to the next topology. Now it's a hub or switch, and all the computers are connected with that central hub. This type of topology is known as star topology. In this topology, there is a dedicated connection to all computers. It has a very fast performance and you can easily upgrade the hub. But installation cost is high and the whole topology is network dependent. That means if hub fails, all the network will go down. Now, moving on to the next topology, there are four computers and a server. And the server is connected to all computers and the computers are interconnected with each other. This type of topology is known as mesh topology. In this topology, it has n minus 2 by 2 channels for n devices. There are two ways of data transfer. One is routing. In routing, the computer or hubs all already know have an algorithm which finds the best and short way to send a data. And another is flooding. In flooding, the data is flooded to all the nodes. Now this topology is robust. It is fully connected and it's secure. And the best example of this topology is P2P connections like uTorrent, BitTorrent, etc. Now moving on to the next topology, it's a main bus, and as you can see there are hubs, and to those hubs there are computer connected in a star formation. Such type of topology is known as tree topology, as this is a combination of two topology, bus and star topology. Now it is used in WAN, that means wide area network, easily expansion of node, that means you can easily connect a lot of devices, a lot of other star networks to it. It is the maintenance of this network is very easy, but it's also central hub dependent. That means if main bus fails, all the network will fail. Now moving on to the next topology. This is the main bus, and as you are seeing, there is a star topology. Along with this, there is a ring topology, and the star ring topology is connected to that central hub. When more than two topologies are combined, then this type of topology is known as hybrid topology. It is used to handle larger volume. In this topology, if any of the computer fails, it is easy to detect and remove. Now it has improved network performance, but on the negative side, it is very expensive MSAU required. That means multi-station access unit, which is used to bypass the faulty devices, is required, and it has a complex design. Now that's all for the topologies. If you have any questions or suggestions, then please comment hit like and share this video with your friends. And if you want to learn more about computer networks, then subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys. Goodbye.